Good morning, dear friends. I am Dr. Reginam Linus, Associate Professor and HOD of Electrical Engineering Department at Sanjay Godavati University, Kolhapur, Maharashtra. Under this electromagnetic series, we looked at how one can convert that unity vector of Cartesian coordinate system to unity vector of cylindrical coordinate system, and unity vector of Cartesian coordinate system. That means I, J, K, 2, U, R, U, T, U, phi, K vector, and U, R, U, phi, U vector, K vector to I vector, J vector, K vector. In this lecture, we are going to learn if you have one vector in Cartesian coordinate, cylindrical coordinate system, how one can convert that into Cartesian coordinate system by using the projection concept. We already know the A vector dot B vector equal to AB into cos theta. So B into cos theta is nothing but the projection of B on A. So we have already studied. So the same thing we are going to implement here to convert the vectors in cylindrical coordinate system to vectors in Cartesian coordinate system. Let me share my screen. This is the last class portions we have studied, this converting IJK to UR UFI UK to IJK, similarly IJK to UR UFI UK. So let me revise the topic. Already what we have learned, if we have these two vector, this is example A vector and this is can be B vector, right? Therefore, we already know this angle between these two will be theta. A vector dot B vector equal to determinant of A vector into determinant of B vector into cos of angle between these two vector. So now, this projection of B on A is B is here, right? So this is example, you can take it as N. So this is O and this is P, right? The projection of B vector on A vector is On. So we have to find out what is On. How we will find out? We know that cos theta equal to On divided by OP. On divided by OP, this is a rectangle. Therefore, adjacent side divided by hypotenuse. On, we don't know. On divided by this OP is nothing but magnitude of B vector, since this is the magnitude of B vector, right? So On, from this On vector, On is equal to magnitude of B into cos theta. We have already know that projection of B vector on A vector equal to B vector dot cos theta. So if we go to the next slide, we can write it again. So from that we can write it, the projection of B vector on A vector can be write it as A vector dot B vector divided by A vector, since B into cos theta is nothing but On. This On is called as projection of B vector on B on A. Therefore, this B on A, B into cos theta, I can write combinedly the projection of A vector, B vector on A vector. Therefore, A vector dot B vector. So already we know this. Another concept that unit vector. What is unit vector? Unit vector is nothing but the unit A vector divided by determinant of A vector. The unit vector of A vector, that means unit vector of A vector, you can write it as UA vector. Can be write it as determinant of A divided by, so vector A divided by determinant of A. So we can write this equation 1 can be write it as projection of projection of B vector on A vector equal to A vector divided by determinant of A vector into B vector dot B vector. So what is A vector dot divided by determinant of A? That is nothing but unit vector. So we can write this will this vector dot product obey the commutative law. Therefore, we can write B vector dot unit vector along the direction of A vector. So this way we can convert all the variables of cylindrical coordinate system to Cartesian coordinate system. That means if B vector projection of B vector on A vector, that means projection of, for example, if we have already the A vector in cylindrical coordinate system, AR into UR gap plus A phi into U phi gap plus A Z into U Z gap. AR into UR gap plus A phi into U phi and A Z into U Z. Now, I want to make all those variables to Cartesian coordinate system. That means projection of A vector, that means this A vector on x-axis in Cartesian coordinate system. So what will happen? Cartesian coordinate system, that means what is we know that particular vector dot the unit vector. So A vector dot unit vector along the direction of x axis is I gap, that is equal to AR into UR gap plus A phi into U phi gap plus A Z into U Z gap dot I vector. Therefore, we already know what is UR vector, what is U phi vector, right? So we can write, substitute now the previous case. What is UR vector? Cos phi into I vector plus sin phi into J vector, right? So we can write, but already we know that UR gap is equal to cos phi into I gap plus sin phi into J gap. Let me check it once again. Yeah, cos phi into I gap plus sin phi into J gap. Then U phi vector is nothing but minus sin phi into I gap plus cos phi into J gap. So let me substitute this. Maybe you can take this equation as equation 2. This equation 2. Therefore, substitute this 2 in equation 1. Maybe you can take it equation 3. Substitute 3 in second equation. Therefore, A vector dot I gap is equal to AR, what is U vector, cos phi into I gap plus sin phi into J gap plus A phi into minus sin phi into I gap plus cos phi into J gap plus what is K vector. This U Z is nothing but K vector, right? K vector is same. Therefore, plus A Z into K gap dot A Z into K gap dot this I gap. So this is the second equation. So we know I dot I, sin I angle between these two vector is equal to 0. So dot product cos of angle between these two will be 1, but J vector dot I j vector dot k, all are zero. Therefore, this k vector dot, this term will be cancelled. This term will be cancelled, and this term will be cancelled. Therefore, a vector dot I gap equal to, we can write AR into cos phi. AR into cos phi, I vector dot I 1 minus A phi into sin phi. You can take equation number 4. Then similarly, we have to write projection of A vector. A vector means A vector in cylindrical coordinate system on Y axis in Cartesian coordinate system. Cartesian coordinate system. So if that is the case, we have to write it again this way. What is that? A vector dot, what is the unit vector along Y axis, dot J gap equal to AR into UR gap plus A phi into U phi gap plus AZ into UZ. Sorry, UZ is nothing but K gap. Since cylindrical coordinate system K is same, dot J. Then substitute the same, this third equation here, we will end up with A dot J vector is equal to AR into sin phi plus A phi into cos phi. So this is equation number 5. Similarly, projection of A vector on Z axis, already we know that A vector dot J vector is K vector is nothing but only K component. So there is no other variable. That means nothing but Z is equal to K is same as this K. Therefore, what we can write? We can write again otherwise, projection of in Z axis, we can write A dot K cap. A dot K is nothing but already A, only the K component dot by dot, so that we will get this only one in the A K gap K, so that we will get only one A vector dot A vector, we will get it one K dot K one, so that we can write it as now all are A dot I means what? A dot I means AZ. So we can write it here. You can write it AZ. Since I will tell you very clearly, AZ A dot. So we know just to substitute here AR into UR gap plus A phi into U phi gap plus A is at in the K dot, K dot K. Therefore, these two will be, there is no variable. In that case, all are zero. So A is at K dot K, that is nothing but A is at. So now, A dot, A vector means A vector in the cylindrical coordinate system. Therefore, A vector dot I is nothing but A x component, and A vector dot J is nothing but A y component, then A vector dot K is nothing but A is a component. So accordingly, we can write it in this matrix form A x, A y, A z. This is nothing but, you have to substitute this, write this all in matrix form, equation number 4 and 5. So therefore, we can write cos phi minus sin phi 0, then sin phi cos phi 0, 0, 0, 1 in the matrix form, that is nothing but A R A phi K, Z. Similarly, already we know it is orthogonal matrix. Therefore, this matrix, if you take this as conversion matrix, C inverse is equal to C transpose. Therefore, we can write AR, A phi, A Z is nothing but just to write this transpose of this matrix, cos phi minus sin phi 0, sin phi, cos phi 0, 0, 0, 1 into AX, AY is. This what we can do for Cartesian to cylindrical and cylindrical to Cartesian conversion. So previously we have studied how to convert this unit vector. Now in this case we will understand how one can convert AX, AY, AZ at all the variables to. So once we in this, what is the main aim of this conversion is, if you know one vector, A vector equal to AX into I gap plus AY into J gap plus AZ into K gap. What is mean by that? This is Cartesian coordinate system. Then another one vector, A vector equal to AR into UR gap plus A phi into U phi gap plus AZ into K gap. What is that? This is called a cylindrical coordinate system. This is called as Cartesian coordinate system. So what, if you know this vector, if you want to convert that into cylindrical coordinate system, use this matrix and convert that into cylindrical coordinates. What is that? You AX, AR, you can substitute this in the AX, AY, AZ, AY in this row and this column, AZ, AZ. So similarly, if you want to convert cylindrical to Cartesian, then again you have to go this previous AX, AY, AZ component, you can get it. This way one can do this conversion in both the cases, cylindrical to coordinate, cylindrical to Cartesian, Cartesian to cylindrical. I hope this this today's portion is understandable. The next class we can do some tutorial problem so that you can easily understand how one can convert Cartesian to cylindrical, cylindrical to Cartesian. I hope you understood the basics, and those who have not subscribed this channel, kindly subscribe. Wish you all the best. Thank you.